father.
Their father. They're not rich.
They're not rich.
Oh boy.
I want holiday sweet for everybody.
I tell you, bro, so I go enjoy you. Enjoy me the sweet.
Tell them.
I tell you,
bro. Oh, but the time you say your skin go still shine rich like this, I'll say that lie.
You know, say if you're not there under pressure, if you're there relaxed, everything could just say, could just go seemingly semi.
You know, you know, say when they talk, say peace of mind.
Yes.
Now you be the best.
Nah, so.
You know, say if you get peace of mind, even water will be sweet.
I tell you.
Because the peace of mind, I ginger the whole matter.
No pressure.
We're well, happy to see you.
I tell you.
Nice.
No,
no
kata
person. No pressure. No pressure. Right, sweet. Oh. All right, our beautiful people. First and foremost, I want to say a very big thank you to all of you, our viewers that got in touch with us, asking, I'll not do portmanteau again, I'll not do portmanteau again. Everyone and others, they say, who they work. They say, they get small time, we go take a groove or enjoy. We just make ourselves take small break and make ourselves go enjoy with our meat that they enjoy. We go, we saw. We conquer, and we came back. We're not dismissed.
We're not stayed there.
We're not dismissed. We came back.
We are there.
We came back.
We came back, and we are there.
We're there.
Are you there?
We're there. I mean, all right, our beautiful people, our brothers and sisters in the Lord, and in other things. Now, with open mind and clear eye, as usual, now we say welcome and come on top the very first episode of the Portmanteau today for the year 2021. And we are happy that you made it through last year. And we are also happy that we also made it through last year. This one that show the Portmanteau well of Nando. And for those of now, we just the watch us for the very first time. Now, me, Osagato, that fine, proud Benin boy, well of now, they call Talk Talk. Nice to see that here, so. And another day here alone, I'm here with that, my honorable guest, my honorable fellow.
That's so, now your boy, Bamidele Okoyemi Bello, where everybody they call MC Bob. We day here, Gidigba. We go to bring out the story. One after the other, from the portmanteau to the
day. All right, gentle people, beautiful people out there. Point where we're there now, at the point where we always go collect our coffee. We just want rush collect the coffee. When we come back, we'll come open the portmanteau, come they bring out the matter them one after the other. We cannot go anywhere with them. Now, so our coffee not change you. Is it get dream taste?
The flavor.
Omo, where I go, I drink coffee.
Ah, I
thought. I drink coffee. You know, say not be this cup where we take the drink of you.
Yeah.
Nah, don't shot. Take her like this. Everything where day your body. If I you take that coffee, Bob. I give you 2 minutes. You go enter White House. No way be White House now. In the restroom.
Oh.
Ah, you go, yeah, you go, let's go. He go push everything, come out.
Okay.
Ah, coffee is good. Bro, coffee.
According to we say, they just discover coronavirus medicine through coffee.
He go sweet.
Ah, because they drink coffee.
Now, after they take coffee, they go. Yeah, coffee is good, but it's advisable not to take more than 3 cups a day. And then you shouldn't take coffee anything beyond 3 p.m. In the afternoon, that is to prevent insomnia, to prevent you from having insomnia. You know what it is, insomnia now?
Yes,
now. You know, if it sleep. You know, another thing where I enjoy for my holiday now, the hotel where I stay.
Ah, flexing.
I stay better hotel. Hotel sweet. Just sleep, wake up. They don't bring food. They don't, you just go play, go call. Life sweet, oh! Hustle, my guy, hustle. Let God pick your call, hustle.
Hey, hustle, tell a story about hotel.
They are not going to tell you a story about hotel. You know, so that one, I lead us into our first story now.
Hey.
As we come back, we just said a quarrel for one hotel. For Ayekpe. Ayekpe, like the hotel day. Then the quarrel, seriously, lodgers. We call lodge for the hotel. They quarrel with the hotel management. Say they put secret camera inside the rooms. So that means say the hotel management now they monitor their movements inside their room. Say they pay for the room. Paying for the room is also paying for their privacy.
That is why they came to pay for hotel. They need privacy. That was why they came to an hotel. Now, the privacy they paid for, they have been deprived of that privacy due to the fact that they discovered that the hotel owners hide secret camera inside the AC. Inside the AC, now they hide those cameras. So, Bob, how you see the matter?
Bro, say na very sensitive issue. If you go ask me, like you ask me. First, I don't know if it's a crime.
Okay.
If it is illegal to have a permit to use CCTV camera, you get planted in rooms,
okay,
in a public place or public private place, so called.
Because hotel now na public private place. Correct.
You get like an hotel room.
Okay.
I don't know what in law actually states. If it is wrong, legally. Now, the angle where me I go like more pick up from bros, you see, what is the motive or the intention of the hotel management to implant cameras in rooms,
okay,
of an hotel? Why will they do that? Number one, if I will answer for them, security reasons. We don't have issues in the time past, bros. We'll be say things will happen in the hotel or in the hotel room and they will go unanswered. Nobody actually witnessed it,
and there will be no record,
and there will be no record,
no nothing to refer to
about what happened. We've had a lot. So I wouldn't know
why.
If that would be the intention of the management to actually say, okay, we are putting up this security
measure
so that we'll be able to apprehend any criminal activity in the room. Are you sure they are not working in collaboration with the Nigerian police force? Are they doing it on their own? Did they actually take that step on their own? These are the questions we should ask.
Okay.
Yes, I think the management should be questioned.
Good, because sorry my brother, because the video that was released, yes, online, the management were not video. The management were not in that video.
Okay.
Maybe to defend themselves.
Mm.
You understand? Maybe to talk for themselves. The video was all about the lodgers.
And they're right.
In that hotel.
And their fears.
That somebody, somewhere, is monitoring their activities in their own hotel room. Are you getting me now?
Yes, bros.
Like
yes.
What we said before, somebody that paid to come and spend some time in a hotel room definitely need some level of privacy.
Definitely.
That's or else they would have gone to a park. Or they would have gone to rent maybe one room somewhere and do whatever they want to do. You get what I'm saying now? But my own argument on this matter is this. The hotel, will it be proper for them to have told their lodgers while they were paying for the rooms that, look, mind whatever you do, we have CCTV cameras in all our rooms? That is to pre-inform them. So if they go ahead and pay for the room, we know that it was a consented thing. They consented, you know, to it.
That's wisdom.
Are you understanding me now? Because there was an hotel I stayed in. They told me everything.
Okay.
They told me there is this in that room, there is that in that room, there is this in this room, there is that in that room. But if you take this room, there is this. They listed everything. So now me now choose the one where I know say it will suit me.
Yes. Of course.
You get what I'm saying now?
Yes,
so
bro,
for those people not to be pre-informed, I see it as not too
bridge
proper. A breach of their privacy, which is what part of what they are paying for. Are you understanding me now? So I believe that is what, because when the guy was
The guy that was in the video was talking. He said they saw my mother's nakedness because my mother, anytime she's coming out of the bedroom, she comes out naked. They saw my uncle's nakedness. They saw, you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I guess the hotel people, I felt the hotel people would have beforehand informed them that, look, oh, in our hotel here, we get CCTV for every room. So make una not do anyhow.
But how person no go do any half day?
No, yeah, now as you don't know, say CCTV day. Mm, yeah, now you go know well. The cuckoo they watch us. Make we do as we like. You know when the
brother go dey do something.
You go dey look CCTV. Be the judge where they watch me now. And the best way they monitor the screen. But they say, see this movie. You know, many people reacted. A lot of people reacted. One of the reactions that also came online was that of Chief Femi Branch.
Yeah.
You know, Chief came out and was so angry that it was a breach of privacy, you know, on the part of the hotel management that it was not good. Mm-hmm. You understand that police should look into the case. May not be like say we just they talk on the show. Our people make una collect the video, make una watch and by ourselves. The two videos, both the one the hotel people where they complain, say that they watch their privacy, and then the one where Femi Branch, Chief Femi Branch also, you know, talked about.
In the hotel we are sleeping at Aikwe, we just found out that there's a camera installed in every room. These were the four we removed from other rooms. Look at them. These are the four we removed from other rooms. This is the fifth one, the fifth room. We've all found out that there's a camera inside. Now I'm going to remove the camera. Look at the camera. Can you see clearly? This is the camera. I'm dragging it out now. This has recorded my brother's nakedness. This has recorded my mother's nakedness, my uncle's nakedness. Because immediately they finish bathing, they come out from the bathroom naked. This is the camera. This is the fifth camera in the room. This is the fifth camera in the room. So you can see. Go closer. So you can see. Alright, this is the hotel. Look, video the hotel surroundings very well so that they won't deny. They won't have evidence against us.
Things happening
in Nigeria.
Inside AC, you would never find out or you would never even figure out that there was a camera installed here.
I mean, what would make somebody put a camera in a hotel? What's the motive? That's my own. What's the motive? I'm calling on the Nigerian police force to arrest the owner and the weather manager or all the operators of Pavilion Hotel and Suites in Ayekwe to do a thorough investigation concerning all the guests that have lodged in that place to find out whether after leaving that hotel, any of them got robbed or got murdered or got kidnapped or anything like that. Because when you're in your room, you are making phone calls, you are disclosing confidential information. If you have money with you, you might have the money spread around the room or something like that. You know, these people could have gotten all manner of information from these cameras in bedrooms. Forget about whether they saw you sleeping with your girlfriend or saw you sleeping with your wife or saw your nakedness or saw your wife's naked. That is trivial. Imagine all the other information that they could have gotten from your private phone calls, your private conversations in those hotel rooms, and what they could have done with all of those information. Do we know whether anybody have lost their lives after lodging in that place? Maybe they will go once they get information and say you get money with you, or they go for one kind of deal, they send armed robbers after you, or maybe anything could have happened. So I'm calling on the Nigerian police to please investigate Pavilion Hotel and Suites in Ayekwe. In Augustine.
See as they para. The guy they para.
They vex everywhere.
You know, pay the guy. I say, they saw my mother's nakedness. They saw my uncle nakedness. Mother's nakedness. Like they pay the guy for so many arati. You know, but Zomzoe, waiting our own house now, is it legal?
Okay.
For the hotel.
Yes, sir.
To do such.
Hey, bros, I'm sorry. It is not, I'm not even sorry. It's not ill. It is a legal thing. Bros, you and I know what is happening around the country today. Insecurities on the high side. I don't want to turn down or turn low on the effort of anybody, government or whatever it's called. But everybody are taking everybody are taking precautions. Everybody are taking one measure or the other to protect themselves. Plus, you know, what do you do for inside your house? For this studio, where we where they come, and they see the security measures where you took in place when they come inside. So everybody, one way or the other, they put one for one security measure or the other to make sure that nothing goes wrong. This is somebody's business. So the only thing is just that they will keep your private life private. Okay. If there is any, if they breach that privacy rule, if they breach it, I guess that is when you can come for them.
Okay.
Yes. And so, but I don't say anything wrong. It's not illegal. It is, in fact, there is a legal standard to back them up to have done such.
And for them, for that hotel to have done that,
yes,
I'm sure there is a legal backing.
Yes, of course.
For it. And then when you look the way where security issue, like what you said, they go on for this country. Now, they don't they pursue banditries, bandits.
Yes.
They don't they pursue their come up for forest.
They don't they pursue them.
They pursue their come up for forest. Mm. You know, they really they smoke them out. Mm. Nigerian military. Mm. On that part, for the past few weeks, I have to applaud them.
Yes.
Because I'm reading and I'm seeing. I have to applaud Nigerian military for doing that wonderful job. Yes. They are smoking out bandits from their hidden places inside forest. Who knows? These bandits have money.
Mm-hmm.
They have money. Yes. They are smoking them out of the forest. They can begin to rent hotel rooms.
Yes. To hide
their kidnapped victims.
Mm.
You get what I'm saying? Yes. Now? So there is nothing that is overrated or overemphasized in this country when it comes to security issues.
Yes.
Me, I see it as a good security measure actually. Yes. But where I have problem with them is what I've mentioned before. They will have informed their lodgers beforehand that look, this is our rooms, this is our hotel, this is the measures we are putting in place because of for security reasons.
Yes.
These are the measures we are putting in place in our facilities. Mm. If you are okay with it, you pay. If you are not okay with it, please go to the next hotel.
Yes.
You understand? So that is just it. So our viewers, that is the much we can take on that matter. People when they quarrel say they see CCTV camera, hidden camera inside their hotel room, that is a breach of their privacy. You too, you can contribute to this matter. You can send us a WhatsApp message on the number scrolling on the screen right now.
That's
and
right.
You can also hit our comment box and let us know your view or what you feel or borrow us sense on top this matter as it is. So, Bobby, second matter where we the chook mark. Many things happen when we come out. plenty things happen when we come
when
out.
We want holiday.
A friend called Nigeria.
Yes.
When did they call now a friend say make help her bring season?
Okay.
Season.
Seasoning.
That's where we made the Maggi. Maggi. You know, say all the seasoning for Nigeria and Maggi.
Now Maggi.
They get their own names over there. Go buy Maggi. Now when the pikin go buy Maggi, come then mama go say, "Shele di moro eni, ani oni 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 pali oni oni kebulu." Go say mommy she be no let me kira Maggi. You know, so the guy say make a friend help and bring seasoning come from Nigeria. Say okay. Nigeria seasoning they stronger than what they see for abroad. So when the guy reached Nigeria, contact that friend people. Okay, the day when he won't go back, no few days to when he won't go back. Night in friend people bring the pack of the season, come give us. Say, see what you help us give our brother from the abroad. Now God, now just say, he go make person they get sense,
yes,
Bob, get sense for this life,
Yeah.
God, now say me that guy get sense, cause he make him even lose this thing. You understand? Now he lose one. Ask me what is inside.
Bros, what is inside?
Igbo. Hey, Indian hemp.
Hi.
Now they rap like seasoning.
Senior bros, now it's inside.
Indian hemp. Therefore, just hold that guy now for airport for drug peddling.
Hey. That's a jail.
Very risky. You won't put your friend for trouble.
Hmm?
May not bless it with a talk. Our viewers, this is reality. You have to be very careful because the times that we are in now are very dangerous. Everybody is looking for way and manner to make money
through
at the detriment of anybody. They don't care who is affected. Ah. They just want to do what? They want to make money or get their way through.
At all costs.
If that guy had not checked that wrapped seasoning, he wouldn't have known. And he would have gotten to the airport, machine go pick him up. Now he go turn Nigerian problem. Say Nigerians are this, Nigerians are drug peddlers.
No.
It's not fair.
That's very unfair. I there is no, in fact, they are not supposed to be friends.
Ah, scheiße.
A friend who will, that's a setup. That's now, so, a setup.
This was even small. We also shown at the video. This was small. You get one where Apple last year. Yam. I don't know that you see that one.
I see that one.
Yam. They scrape, they cut the yam, scrape the inside.
I don't.
Come load drugs
inside,
cocaine inside. Come take the other half, put them. Come super glue them. Gary give him friend, make help and give him brother for abroad.
Kai,
that one too. When that one they pack, you know, say super glue don't hold something, don't they don't weak. As that one they pack, now the yam break into two. Now you can't see what they load. Say now cocaine. Inside yam. May not bless it with just a talk. Our viewers, make una watch
this. The content of this non-maggi that a friend gave to a friend to bring to abroad. So, look at
it.
The content is not really maggi, rather it's Indian hemp.
Let me open it so you can see. Well packaged. This is the first layers. Look at it.
Wonderful.
Can you imagine? The extent who can go.
Making money.
So if you see somebody selling biscuits, driving Jeep.
Don't be deceived.
Don't kill yourself over it because you don't know what you do. Be contented with what you have. Can you see? With sellotape, masking tape, because you want to make money at the expense of others. Can you see?
Put it on the table.
Yeah, I will. Can you see?
This is Indian hemp.
Marijuana.
Marijuana. Popularly called Igbo in Nigeria.
Person where don't manage escape Nigerian problem. They want to return her back to Nigeria.
Bros, Nigerian problems.
They want to return the guy back. So see the guy carry that now reach airport for that side, they can't go deport him. Because if he cross our airport here, there. At that side we they talk.
The guy, machine will go feed dictate anything.
You know, it's very bad, it's very absurd. Viewers, you have to be very careful. The times that we are in are very, very dangerous. And everybody is just trying to make it at all costs, trying to make it by all means. The other day too, we see some guys, they bath for public, for open, big, matured boys, they bath just for this thing, to make money.
Aye, desperate.
Meanwhile, do you know that to make money is the easiest thing?
I tell you.
Now just to put your head down, think, see what is going on, align yourself with it, legitimately, then you roll.
Yes. Solving need,
meeting need,
solving problems,
seeing a loophole, occupying, filling up a loophole. There was something a Proko doctor did. You know, a Proko doctor is an influencer on Twitter. You know, there was something he posted a few days ago.
Okay.
You know, I saw the tweet and I thought deep in my heart. There was an Indian woman that was holding a bedroom slippers in her hand. Apropos doctor now wrote under that caption. Now wrote a caption under that picture that here we are eating up our leather as pomo. Meanwhile, some people we can turn pomo to forex.
It's shaking
to foreign exchange.
let us ban Pomo.
No, not be ban. Let's convert Pomo to more meaningful way of more meaningful and that means.
Bro, people no go chop Pomo again.
No, be saying no go.
They
chop.
Go reduce.
They go reduce. They go use that if you
the cash Afroko.
No, Afroko doctor a big boy.
You go not that
Afroko.
Say what you talk.
Afroko doctor a big boy.
But my way, you will be survive being alternative.
No, it's okay.
Boy, it's a wise boy.
Yes, of course. You make more for out of Momo.
Yes, of course.
Not than Momo. Just consuming it.
Than just shitting it.
Export our leather to India. Let them use it.
Export our Momo.
As leather wear, whatever. Then. Use it to augment, you know. So bro, now so they be.
Not true.
Now so they be.
Too much sense.
I mean, we make we not go anywhere. Make we take this short break. When we come back, we call it the final matter. We enter inside the portmanteau today. Welcome back to the portmanteau today. Now me Osagato, that fine, proud Bini boy. All of now they call Talk Talk. Nice to see that. Yes. So, and I still day inside the studio continuously and continually. Yes. With my homeboy, my main man, my honorable fellow.
Yes, I see your boy Babidele Okpemi Bello, aka MC Bob, still day studio.
With the Naka. Big.
Big Yoruba boy.
The big black Yoruba boy.
Ross here.
You don't go Jebadu forget. You don't go Jebadu forget your Ricky. You go Jebadu forget your Ricky.
Now you give me that Ricky.
Asso. Alright, ladies and gentlemen. The next matter we will handle on top of the portmanteau today. And I don't want to concern Lagos State. I won't call her now. Lagos State boss,
Lamata.
Lamata, Lagos State moto, Lagos. Forget. I'm on a yacht like that. If you know the full meaning of Lamata, your air force.
Lagos State management.
Oh my, you fuck come. Forget. I mean, my people. If you know the full meaning of Lamata, just help us fill in the Lamata. Gap. Lamata people,
okay.
Through their managing director, where be Madam Abimbola Akinyaju.
Okay.
Madam Abimbola Akinyaju. Don't talk and say beginning from February.
Yeah.
Say from February. Lamata, that is Primero.
Primero.
Primero bosses, that blue BRT. Yes. So they're not going to collect cash.
Okay.
Again, everybody now will go on Kauri card. You know, that is their card where they tap in. You know, so no more cash payments for tickets. What you do now is collect, pick up the card, you load your card. So anywhere where they go, now to just join queue. When the bus come, you tap in, then say go be. The bus go they carry you there.
Well. Bros, if you go ask me, a very fine development.
Okay.
Because me, I still see it as a way of reducing cash flow in a way that everybody will start needing cash flow. We are still talking about cashless society.
Okay.
It's still one way helpful. But my question be say, you know, say with the state we be say we are still battling between the literate and the illiterates. Now we know very well that people who plow this route, who dig through these buses, usually don't have the luxury of time to get cards to start loading cards. What are the measures put in place that people can get their cards conveniently? She person will be say they go walk maybe 4 a.m. 5 a.m. He no go come back us until, let's say, 10, 11. And he relies so much on those bosses to take him to his decision and bring him back conveniently. And he has his cash. He will not, what time does he really have to go and queue up wherever they have their arrangements to get the card? Getting the card, loading it. I think there should be measures put in place that will not make no people. You see the issue of NIN. You know our people, you go through stress to get things done. What are the measures put in place that will be very convenient, that will be easy? I hope that they will have outlets, just like we buy recharge card.
Yeah.
that we have okay easily that you can just pick
load,
it up.
Pick your card and load it.
You'll get.
Actually, on the communique that was sent to us, they didn't write the measures that they've put in place. They didn't state the measures that has been put in place. But I'm sure that for them to come out with this kind of a regulation or a regulation, they will have put in a lot of thoughts, a lot of thinking into it. They will have put in, invested a lot of thinking into it and making sure that, you know, it's BRT is almost, we know it's a state-owned thing, and it's also almost a private-owned thing, because they are not the only one in that business. People have choice.
Yes, they are.
So they will not want to do what will chase away their customers. You understand what I'm saying now? So I'm sure they will, with these measures, is they will have put in place a basis to make all getting the card easy for their commuters. You understand? Or else people will just, like you said, Nigerians don't have the luxury of time. When I wait, they are not sitting, I don't see card pick up, I don't enter downfall.
We don't
move.
Go. Anymore.
And you know, this thing, this card issue, they've been operating it, you know, from the Oshodi Abule Egba corridor.
Okay.
You understand? The Oshodi Abule Egba corridor, you can't buy tickets with money. You must have card. There was a day I wanted to use one of their buses from Ilepo to Oshodi. I entered the bus. I went to the terminal to go and buy it. They said, no, I have to have card. You know, when the bus actually came, it was only those people that had card that the bus picked. So I had to go back and enter LT35. You know LT35. So now LT35, I got carry me reach Oshodi that day. Like I said, it's a welcome development. Okay. We appreciate it. Like you said, it's for cashless economy. It helps in improving our economy cashlessly. Yes. And then it goes to help people like us. All those, they are ticketers. They know they ever get change. They know they ever get change. Now all that one go stop.
They go stop.
They will carry our change. How much where they live? Yeah. Boss, we don't have 50 naira change. Yeah. Okay, leave
with
it.
Rush,
boss, right? With the rush. 50 naira we don't live for those who reach me to buy tickets from there to Benin.
I tell you.
And like what the woman was saying, that they also brought up this to protect investors' fund. So that investors will get quality returns on their investment. So dear viewers, we just want to bring it to your notice that starting from February, BRT bus Lagos Ikorodu to TBS corridor go stop to the collect cash for tickets. So make sure say you go get your cowrie card, load your card, just join line.
Easy.
Say go back to CBS. Bobby, and also go take drop the show today. Madam Abimbola Akinajo, we say thank you for sending us that communique. And also the Assistant Director Corporate Communication of Lamata, Mr. Kolawole Ojelabi. Now he signed that communique where they sent to us. So ladies and gentlemen, our viewers at home, please, let's not forget that coronavirus is still very active in our midst. It's still killing people here and there. And like it was reported, it's only those countries that has money that has been buying the vaccine. And now, sir, we don't even the turn lobby. Some country now, because they get money past some other country, they call they go the order. I say they want to buy the whole thing, close the buy the whole factory where they produce the vaccine.
But thank God,
say World Health Organization don't they put check on all those things. They want to make sure the vaccine go round. You know, very soon it will get to Africa, and I in Nigeria they make plans to go and buy.
They say they won't create.
They want to do their own, but at the same time they want to buy.
They want buy.
Say, how many billion?
Like, 10 billion.
10 billion. Mark, was it 10 billion? So,
10 billion.
Be 30 billion. Go do ticker well.
That's a billion gang.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. So coronavirus is still very, very active. Anywhere they go, make sure say they apply your nose mask properly. Make sure say regularly they wash your hand with soap and water. Not let your sanitizer far from you. The normal 2 meter gap, what they say, they give ourselves for public. Not forget to observe them anywhere where you did. Last, make you remember say you be Ninja. Anywhere you did, they represent this country well. Not for they put hand for waiting go spoil this country name. Not do drugs because you don't get any better thing where they do for body. From me, Osagato, and then from my very honorable fellow, Bamdele Opeyemi Bello, all of us say, make una hold in our chest tight. Until we come again, we say make una rep well.
Zoom.